Hi everybody, Melodico here. I'm in the burning woods, sitting over here at the Skyfire zone line, and today I'm going to show you how to gather mobs and kite them down. I won't be going into too much detail on how to actually perform a swarm, there's a lot of videos out there already, but I'll touch a couple topics that might be beneficial to you. Now one thing I want to note right off the bat is the direction you're facing. We're going south. I have my hotkeys mapped to sense heading, left and right. Basically what we're going to do is loop around the whole zone in a big circle, and then we're going to come back to this spot. This is the location we're at, 4,1700. I like to keep a little hotkey. Helps me tell where I'm going in this forested zone. So let's get started. We're immediately going to hook a left and head east. Now you really want to be on the lookout for Sarnax. Worms and giants are bad news too, but they're pretty easy to dodge. They're huge. So remember, if you ever pull a Sarnax, even if it's a champion, just zone your pull. It sucks, yeah, but it's a lot better than dying in a corpse run. So when you see mobs you can pull, you can either use two yins to safely pull, or use social aggro like that. The hornets and the gorillas are social mobs, so you can pull them by dragging your swarm through them. Oh god. See, they kind of sneak up on you. They're everywhere, those lizard men. You always want to keep silos on, you don't want to get caught by your swarm. But yeah, if you pull a skeleton, they're not social, so you need to be especially careful. You can either body pull or two-yins them. So I keep kind of heading east until I run into this fort over here, picking up mobs on the way. Sarnax tend to path through these forts, so you need to be a little bit cautious. You always want to be looking around for where a Sarnax might be coming from. But every little mob you see, it's all just more experience, so go for all of it. You can body pull mobs if you want like that, just be careful. If you're not paying attention and you cut it too close, you might get stunned and killed. There's a crater over here we might try pulling from, but for now, uh-oh. Also, look out for getting caught on logs and such. Generally, you want to keep a little distance from your swarm in case you do make a small mistake. If you don't see any Sarnax, you can usually kind of run through, body pull as many as you can. I will tell you, doing what I just did is a little risky, and in some cases it doesn't even work. But this is the beginning of my pull, so naturally I'd take a few more risks than I would if I'd been pulling for 10 minutes. I'm going to try to pick up these front skeletons. Now, it is great for massive pulls to pick up everybody, if you can, but there's so many mobs in the zone. If you happen to miss a skelly, just move on. Time is experience in this game, and money, so you're better off just moving along and keeping a pretty quick pace. Even if you don't have the biggest pull in P99 history, you'll probably be happier for it. Now one thing you want to be aware of if you're using silos with a drum, like I currently am, is that you don't outrun your swarm. It's easy to forget how fast you are unless you play an alt. Generally, if I still have pretty good HP, I'll leave my drum on and kind of kite in circles. You always want to be looking around you. If you just sit here waiting for the swarm, a Sarnax is going to come up on you, I promise you. And you could basically run the circle I'm showing you around this map a couple times if you really want, but I don't think it's worth the risk of dying and losing your invested time, so try to keep your swarm to somewhere around 70 to 100 mobs on average, I'd say. It doesn't even matter really, you could also do like a quick 50 mob pull if you don't have a lot of time to play. The big ones from start to finish until the mobs die could take upwards of 45 minutes to an hour. Quicker ones, maybe 30 minutes. Make sure you've given yourself enough time before you start. There is a crater here, and these can be really good. It's really dangerous getting to the top of the crater right here, because a Sarnak can sometimes come running around the bend. It doesn't look like there's a whole lot of mobs. You want to be careful that you don't accidentally run back into your swarm if you lose your direction a little bit. Also, I haven't really talked about it much, but when you see an ape, you have to target them and make sure they're not guller back. There's something like 3 to 4 guller backs in the zone, and if you pull one, you might be able to get away with kiting them down, but it's also possible he'll summon you, which will immediately kill you. So it's better to just avoid the risk. Alright, we got a pretty decent swarm for not being too far from where we started. Let's go ahead and move on. Remember to use Tuyans to pull whenever you want to be safe. I'll try to body pull those. If anything, I'll let the swarm social aggro these guys. I'm sure you're familiar with that. Your bard. Here's another. Oh god. Don't do that. But once again, it won't kill you. One thing nice about being a bard is having safe fall. There's usually quite a few hornets in here, and I don't normally see Sarnax in this particular crater. So it's a good spot to pull. There is some mystery skeleton guy here. I'm more pro bard might know what he does, but I don't, so. And I'm too lazy to wiki it. So I just avoid him. Pick up a couple hornets here or there. Usually get, I don't know, 7 or 8 when I run through here on average. Pretty safe spot to round up mobs too, so I like this area. Just pay attention to the elevation. Make sure you don't get yourself killed. Okay. If you get turned around, just get yourself out of the crater any way you want. And then remember, at the very beginning, we were heading east. We're going to keep heading east until we kind of hit a wall, and then we're going to head south. And then once we get far enough south, we'll head west, and then back north to complete our loop. How far east you go at the beginning, aka right now, is up to you. You could actually cut south right now if you so wanted. But we'll go east a little bit more. There's more mobs to get. Well, nah, let's just go south. I don't want this video to be like 5 hours long. Just keep in mind, you could keep heading east. Now I'm turned around. Eh, whatever. We'll go south. Guess this would be east. Pick up a skelly. When you see a Sarnak, make sure he doesn't randomly start sprinting. It may look like he won't catch you, but they are unpredictable and they hide behind trees. They're terrible, terrible things. Well, at this part of the pull, everything's pretty wide open, so unless I'm not paying attention or I get really unlucky. I like to throw on my loot. I still have enough speed to stay far ahead of my swarm, but then I can twist my Hymn of Restoration and Nims. Start healing up. Now it is true you don't really need HP to swarm, but if you're going to be body pulling mobs and you happen to get stunned, having HP can be really helpful. You also want to make sure you don't outrun your mob here, it'd be easy to do. Ah, here's another big crater. We can go see what's in there. You see, you don't get quite as much distance with this method. So if you happen to get stunned, it's a little bit more risky. Just like that. If mobs are ever catching up on you, you probably know, but you should run and strafe. It gives you a little bit of extra distance. Oh, we're back at the same crater. Look at me, turned around. It's fine. So let's head south. That's a good landmark to see. That means we're kind of at the south wall. Now we can look to start heading east to continue our circle. This huge wall is where the zone line to DL lies. A lot of Sarnax in this area, so I'm going to be paying close attention to make sure they don't sneak up on me. Not a whole lot of mobs in this area right now, but see this hill here? This is the actual path that leads to DL. I'll look around a little bit. Just past that DL path, there's usually a ton of mobs. So I'm not sure if there's another bard in the zone swarming too, but this is usually crawling with monsters. Yeah, we got two bards in the zone actually, so this video isn't going to have nearly as many mobs as if you have the zone to yourself. A lot of hornets spawn along the wall, but you need to be careful because lots of Sarnax too. Beginner pullers in this zone kind of tend to only pull hornets because they're a little scared of gorillas and Sarnax, and there are some pretty safe spots to only pull hornets. So, you'll normally see a lot more skellies and gorillas than hornets if the zone is populated. Well, at this point, I should probably heal up a little bit. I've been a little sidetracked with the video and looking out for lizard men. But that's fine. Just make sure you never let silos drop, and if you do, you're prepared to strafe away until you can get it back up. If your swarm's a bit behind you, I like to pull one mob sometimes and let him be the social aggro. Then I have one tiny swarm and one massive swarm. They'll end up lining back up. These runes are a big marker. Once you've reached here, you're really close to the hornet nest, which is up there, basically in the corner of the map. The southwest corner. Now pay attention to how close the mobs are behind you here, because it's probably easiest to body pull these mobs, but there's a good chance you'll get stunned. There are safer ways to do it if you don't like taking risks, like I do. But generally, social aggro will pick up almost all of them. If you miss one or two, no big deal. Sometimes I come up here, It's usually quite a few floating around this general area, overlooking the hive. There's also usually a few between the valleys, but I'm not going to go there this time. I think for the most part, we've got enough mobs to give you the basic idea. If you want to tack on extra little paths or pick up stragglers, go for it. Every mob is a little bit more experience, so more power to you. Just occasionally check behind you and make sure the mobs aren't too close or too far. Now, once you leave these hills where the hornets are, things get a little bit risky again with Sarnax and such. We're basically at the point where we're about to head north this direction to finish our loop. And this will take us straight to Skyfire, basically. As you can see, ooh, I let CeeLos drop. Dangerous. Lot of Sarnax around here. Very, very risky. That fort there has quite a few skellies in it. Maybe eight, I believe. Sometimes I like to pull the entrances if I feel like I can safely. Sometimes I feel it's not even worth the risk. Picking up a couple extra mobs for a 5% chance of running into a Sarnak and having to zone the whole thing. I usually deem this whole runes area unsafe and avoid it when I have a large pull. If my pull is smaller than I'd like, sure, I might go in there and see what I can pull off. But the more comfortable you get with the zone, feel free to take those chances if you want. If you're safe about it, you can usually get away alive. You're just going to lose 10 to 15 minutes of pulling time, which can be very frustrating, but remember, surviving is always more important than any single pull. Surviving and getting all the experience you can is also more important than any loot you can get doing this. Typically, when you're doing very large pulls, I'm just gonna follow the north wall, a little safer. Actually, you know what? You can throw on CeeLo's Song of Travel here. The mobs are still gonna be on you, but that way you don't aggro Sarnax. They don't have CMBiz, so it's safe. You must be wary though, because giants and skeletons do have CMBiz. They will ruin your dreams. Plus, when you break CeeLos, you run slow, so you put yourself at risk. I guess you could say what I'm doing right now. Oh god, a zealot just spawned there. Not good. Yeah, what I'm doing right now is pretty risky. The worst thing that can happen is the Sarnax spawning on your face. And yes, it does happen. Especially when you have bard speed and you run all over the zone. Just never get complacent until the pull is over. It's pretty easy to feel comfortable during a pull when things are going well. And then all it takes is 1 second of zoning out or not focusing and a skelly you didn't see stuns you, a hornet stuns you again, and you're dead. Pretty big swing going on a 40-minute corpse run, trying to get a revive if you can, or getting a full yellow of experience at level 53. Let's see. Oh, 52. 3 blues away. Not bad. You can actually start doing this zone as early as, I believe, level 45. The pull might take longer, but the experience would be off the chain. If you are level 45, it's generally safer to do something like DL, because you're going to have this zone until level 60. There's not a whole lot of options. Okay, see this fort? That's a good marker that we've head north and east quite a bit. So here I usually tap my location, Remember, we're looking for about 4,1700. So you'll see if we keep heading this way over this hill, as we approach 4,000, there's this little mouth of the valley that we've discussed in length. This is actually the zone into Skyfire. You want to look back, make sure your mobs are coming. From here, we should be pretty set. I'm going to switch to normal silos. And basically, soon we're going to be able to begin our kite. Let's throw on the drum. As I expect, if you're a roughly level 50 bard and you're trying to learn how to kite BW, you probably know what you're doing already. Kind of an odd time to begin swarming, but hey, it's never too late. Swarming is fun, and obviously it levels you fast. So this front rock here, this is what I'm going to be circling the whole time I'm here. Kind of where the grass and the black part of the ground meet, that's where you want to be. This is a zone line. You don't want to go near those rocks. If you accidentally go too far, you're gonna zone your swarm, and well, then you're gonna zone in and try to recover them all, and maybe you'll succeed, or maybe you'll get yourself killed. Anyway, that's gotta have them all rounded up by now, I'm sure. Yeah, look at that. Nice and tight. So, I'm gonna bring them around, and then I'm going to begin my auto run strafe method, which I'm sure you know. Auto run, hold right click, left and right, enter. Let's turn off silos too. That's not gonna help. So now that I'm auto running, all I'm doing is using right click. You probably know this already, but if you're using a different swarming method, you should really switch to this one. It's easier, safer, and if you happen to lag spike, it doesn't necessarily mean you're going to die, like with the other methods. So I just keep right turning in. This is roughly the size of the circle you want. The more you turn in, the closer the mobs are going to get to you. You want to be all the way zoomed out. Oh, look, Denon's hit, so. You can always leave an instrument on your cursor. That way you can cycle through your three dots. See, there's the second one, Silo's chord of cessation, and then chords of dissonance. Looks like I missed. I'll try to get a little closer. Well, I'm not going to force it. Let's go back to DDD. DDD almost always hits, although that only hit six or seven guys, so let's try that again. Rule of thumb, try to land all three, but if it takes too long, each dot only lasts for four ticks, so just switch back. It's almost always safer to stay alive than to go for a quick kill. Well, that's kind of an obvious thing to say, isn't it? But getting that extra damage with all three dots does go a very long way in the speed of the pull. Also, if you want to end up looting the mobs, it's pretty important. But if you're cutting it close by turning into the mobs a little bit too much, don't take the risk. Play it safe, stay on the outside of what would land, and go for the experience. Always more important. I mean, we've already invested, what, 25 minutes? I mean, you would know better. You're the YouTube watcher. That's about what it feels like, though. Well, I missed him, but here's DDD again. As you level up, I'm sure you know, every other level, your dots go up by 2 damage. Also, this Silo's Chords of Cessation song can be very beneficial when you get a little bit higher level than I am, because it's got a minus magic resist element. So when it hits, sometimes your songs critically hit, and they could hit for up to 60 a tick. Yeah, I have a 54, 55 bard friend who was basically saying between his three dots, he usually hits for about 150 a tick. Looks like I'm coming in a little under that, maybe around 105, 110 a tick, which is pretty good. Each dot hits four times. It is true you can only hit 25 mobs at a time using this method, but if you keep cycling through all three, you can actually tag, you know, 50 mobs at a time during some of those windows. Oops. So it's definitely worth going for a big pull over a bunch of 25 mob pulls. People might complain and say it's better the other way, but I've tried it and it is not. So you probably already noticed, but the mobs come into your screen a little bit when you cut it close trying to land the shorter range songs. That's okay, but if they start taking up too much of your screen, or if you have lag, either way, you need to start being cautious. And oh, look at that. See that lag spike? As you'll see, I stopped turning when that happened, because when you let yourself go and auto-run just like this, it gets you more distance between the mobs. When you're trying to cut in and land your songs, generally you want to be right-click turning in right before the song hits. But it just takes a little practice and then you get used to it. Even if you're not perfect, you're going to be getting mad experience, so by the time you're level 60, you'll be perfect, because it's going to take quite a lot of pulls to get there. Now, one thing I really need to mention is hide corpse all. Looks like I missed it. There we go. If you don't have a hide corpse button that's easily ready to click, eventually you're going to screw up. And I can tell you this from experience. You're going to be right-clicking to turn, and you're going to loot a mob, and then all of your dreams in life will end. And you'll be so sad. So, every once in a while, when you start seeing the corpses line up, just give that button a little tap. You'll thank yourself. Now, one thing to be cautious of is if a different person in the zone happens to train a Sarnak caster to the zone line. It sucks, especially if you're this deep into the pull, but if you can't get away from its aggro range and you know it's going to aggro you, be ready to zone it all. Gotta be able to walk away from the experience. Oh my god. Lag spikes like that are what make this so exhilarating, I guess you'd say. I've had lag spikes so bad where it actually turns me 180 and I run straight into the mobs. I had one fun experience where actually doing that didn't kill me. I got away with 10% health. I have no idea how. It was a miracle. Okay, these mobs are getting really close to me. I don't know if it's lag or what, so I'm gonna try to get some distance here. You want to be careful starting your right click when there's a corpse on the ground too. Probably time for another hide corpse, but given how fast we kill, there are gonna be corpses even if you click hide corpse all the time. So make sure you don't loot them. Oh my god. How fun. Now remember, I'm 3 blues from 53, so that should be a decent gauge as to how much a medium-large pull in this zone can bring you. Also, the loot here can be quite good. While it is true, when you do a larger pull, you don't always get to loot all the mobs. When you get to a little higher level and you have better instruments, there is a good chance your AE DPS is better than mine, and you might actually get to loot everything. You can make 500 to 1,000 platinum a run. The Hornets tend to drop rare gems. You can get a Ruby Crown, which is like 200 plat. Sapphire or Fire Emerald is quick 80 plat or so. And every mob drops maybe two. Oh my god! That was some pretty scary lag. Gotta be cautious. Say you accidentally do get hit and you manage to escape. It goes without saying, but the first thing you should do is start strafing away and jumping at the same time and try to get silos off ASAP. And then just, you know, regroup yourself. Oh, there we go. Now, if you're looking for more detailed guides on the actual swarming process, there are some YouTube videos by Atmospheric, one of my bard friends on this game. He gives a really good overview on the basics of swarming. Should help you out. Also, you can pretty much ask any bard on this server. If you look at my friends list, you'll see most of them are bards. We have our own little secret alliance thing going on. Let's see who's on. Well, I don't have a whole lot of friends on, but you could see 50% of them are bards, for what that's worth. Sethiel and Heathcliff are both really good bards I've learned quite a bit from. Compton is a great bard. Now, I'm talking at the beginning of April, so you know P99. The people on here change all the time. But if you happen to see this and not long after it was made, yeah, those are some good references for you. Well, I'd like to say I'm getting near the end of the poll, but hard to tell. When I see my dot land, it still looks like I got a 20 or so mobs, so might be a bit to go yet. Just stay focused, oh my god, and pray that doesn't happen, or if it does, that you're lucky enough to get away. And it really does depend on how hardcore you are with gaming, but if you're a normal person who considers themselves adequate or above at gaming, it might be wise to take a break between your pulls. I know as soon as I finish this pull in this video, I'm gonna go watch a King of the Hill episode. Do a little unwinding, make myself a little snack, get myself a drink. Now that kinda sounds like personal preference, but take it as advice, because when you're staring at the screen and giving a pull like this the focus it deserves, you're going to make mistakes if you don't take breaks. That's just the way it is. And if you happen to be having a bad day and you're making mistake after mistake, hey, ding, hooray. The big 5-3. My reward is I get to do this for another 7 levels. Now, it's probably a good idea to group as you go too. You know, try to work on your epic. I might start looking for a KC group, try to get that Drolvarg Warlord drop. Because if you go all the way to 60 like this, I mean, that's great, but then you're just going to be grouping in those zones at a higher level than you need to be, so two birds with one stone, you know? Plus, you don't want to hit level 60 and have no idea how to group as a bard. Gotta have some kind of balance. Although I'm really not the person to say that. I made my character, about 5 weeks ago, although I've hardly played the past week. This is my first character on P99, so goes to show you anyone can do it. I mean, I've played P99 in the past, and I played Everquest Live, so I'm not a complete noob, but Bard is a great class if you want to get up to max level end game content right away. Now, once again, I'm stating the obvious, but that's what happens when you focus on running in a circle too hard. Your mind starts going crazy. You also tend to get a little bit lazier with your circles. I don't know if you noticed, but my circle's starting to look kind of like, I don't know, a kindergartner trying to draw a circle. Well, I feel at this point, even if I did screw up and get hit, I'd probably get away with it. Let's hide corpses again. Now, one thing to keep in mind, generally the bard that's here first and is kiting has precedence, but there are no server rules about it, so if you see another bard kiting here when you decide to get online, shoot him a message and see how long he's going to be on. That's a polite thing to do. Generally, they'll take into consideration that you'd like to swarm to, and you can usually work something out. I haven't really seen it where two bards tried kiting in this area at the same time, but there are really no other safe areas in the zone to kite, as far as I know. Once again, I've only been on the server for a couple weeks, so I don't know everything. But if everyone in the community takes the time to contribute and help each other out, make tutorial videos, or answer noob questions, go to Crushbone and encourage people to play a little bit longer with a little PL, the Norathian world will be a little bit better. I believe it was John Lennon who said that. Of the Beatles. The band. You can target nearest monster and see what HP the mobs are at too, if you want. It's sometimes nice when you don't get a couple stragglers at the end, but it happens. I don't really worry about the mobs that run off like that Mulder and Gorilla. Uh-oh. No biggie. Maybe I'll get a defense skill up. At this point, maybe I should care a little bit and get myself killed. Just like, I just killed 100 of you, what are two gonna do? Then I get the "you are dead" message. Crap. But yeah, you can kind of freestyle it at this point. Throw in a two-ins, do whatever you want. As soon as one dies, the other one will run. And then you can throw on your slash hide corpse none and try to get as much loot as you can. Throw on silos too. What the hell? Never seen that loop before. Well, that pretty much wraps up the video. I'm not gonna keep you guys here as I selfishly loot all these crystalline sulfurs, so Thanks for tuning in, and see you around. Feel free to ask me questions in the game. My name's Melodico.